Welcome to another Hoshizaki technical training video. My name is David Rivera. Today, we'll be walking you through the sequence of operation of an IM-50BAA-Q ice machine. If you'd like to view our manuals or other documentations for a Hoshizaki unit, like the sequence of operation or our flowchart, please visit hoshizakiamerica.com/support/manuals. Be sure to include dashes when entering your model number. After you click go, you will see the various materials for the particular units. For the IM-50BAA-Q, the sequence of operation can be found on page 10 of the service menu. Now let's dive into the sequence of operation. First, switch the unit into the ice position. The control display will show on and the startup cycle will begin. During the startup, the hot gas valve energizes. After a 30-second delay, the compressor starts, initiating the initial harvest cycle. At this stage, the water tank is in the down position. The thermistor on the top of the evaporator should read 50 degrees Fahrenheit or higher. This triggers the next stage of harvest. The inlet water valve and the actuator motor energize. The actuator motor drives the tank upward, closing the water tank. The harvest cycle ends when the tank is fully closed, verified by the water plate switch and the cam position switch showing closed. Once the tank closes, the free cycle begins. The pump motor energizes, the reservoir begins to overflow. After 15 seconds, the water valve and the hot gas valve de-energize. The machine continues to freeze until the evaporator reaches -4.9 degrees Fahrenheit, at which point the freeze cycle ends. After the freeze cycle ends, the unit returns to harvest cycle. The inlet water valve and the actuator motor energizes, and the actuator moves the tank downward. When the cam position switch activates, the compressor de-energizes and the actuator motor pauses. At this point, the water fills the tank, submerging the bottom evaporator overflowing into the drain pan. This helps thaw the ice from the lower evaporator. The tank will continue opening after either the cam position turns off based on a timer, or the water plate switch turns off and the ice separates early, allowing the tank to drop slightly by its own weight. Typically, the timer is 5 minutes, as the water temperature should be below 55.4 Fahrenheit during this normal harvest. When either switch turns off, the water valve de-energizes and the actuator motor continues to drive the tank down until it fully opens. Once the evaporator thermistor reaches 50 degrees, the water valve energizes and the actuator motor closes the water tank. Once closed, the machine begins free cycle again. The machine will continue to cycle between freeze and harvest until the bin is full. When the bin control is triggered, the machine completes the current harvest, then shuts down all components. Once the bin control is disengaged, the unit will restart sequence of operation from the beginning. Before we wrap up, this is one important detail to cover regarding the springs and installation of an IM machine. When we're replacing springs on an IM machine and you're attaching the springs to the cam and to the actuator, after installing the spring, you need to go back with some channel locks and tighten where they attach to. They need to be a perfect circle. If they look like an open mouth Pac-Man, they're open up too wide and they need to be closed down. This only applies when you're installing the spring brand new. After the spring is stretched out, there is no going back. At that point, the spring is gonna have to be replaced. Broken springs could cause damage to the unit. To avoid any issues, please double check your springs.
Thank you for watching this video. For more videos like this, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also offer a virtual and in-person training course on Hoshizaki products for technicians. If you're interested in this, go to hoshizakiamerica.com/support/training or scan the QR code on the screen. For any further assistance, you can contact us by phone or at email. The contact details are on the right side of the screen. Again, thanks for watching.